again, in our previous video, in the previous video, we looked into nationalism generally, and we looked into the proto-nationalists and the other side, or the other nationalists that were not proto. And also, we looked into the internal factors that aided nationalist activities in Nigeria. So now, we'll be looking into the external factors that aided nationalist activities in Nigeria. Among the external factors that aided nationalist activities in Nigeria were, one, we have the Atlantic Charter. The Atlantic Charter. Charter of 1941. We have the independence. The independence of India and Pakistan. Also, we have the return of ex-servicemen. Also, we have the activity of British Labour Congress. And the last one, I think, will be considering as one of the factors is the agitation of United Nations. Agitation of United Nations. So, these are the factors we shall be looking to examine the activities of nationalists in Nigeria. So, we said one of the external factors that aided nationalist activities in Nigeria is Atlantic Charter of 1941. Atlantic Charter of 1941 is an agreement that was signed by the world powers, between the world powers. For what? For all countries that is taking other nations, other countries as a colony, should give them independence, should grant them independence as soon as what? As they request for it. Because what? Colonialism breach fundamental human rights, breach of course sovereignty. So then, colonizing an African nations is an act of breach of our sovereignty. So, by this regard, there was an agreement among the world leaders that whichever country, whichever European country or superior country that is colonizing any other country in Africa or to other world countries should be excused, should be granted independence without any further delay. So, this charter goes a long way to what? To aid the nationalist activities in Nigeria. To what? To ensure that they attain independence as soon as possible. So, we cannot underestimate the importance, the impact, and the effect of the Atlantic Charter of 1941 as one of the external factors that aided nationalist activities in Nigeria. Secondly, we have the independence of India and Pakistan. Yes, both India and Pakistan were colonized as Nigeria, and all other African countries were colonized. So to the surprise of Nigeria, in 1947, India was granted independence, you know? Like, you'd be like, we are mates now. We are both being colonized. How come this one happened? What am I doing? I must double my house. You know, understand that kind of thing. When you see your mate already driving, you can be like, what is it doing that me? I'm not doing. Let me double my house. That was the situation of things in Nigeria then. We were being colonized with India. So to our surprise, India was granted independence. We were like, what has India done right? That we're not doing. What would have been the reason? So for that, wasn't what? We doubled our house, we doubled our struggle, we doubled our fight, we doubled our agitation. And our nationalists left no stone unturned to ensure that Nigeria had independence as soon as possible. So the independence of other countries was like a motivation for us to what? For us to also attain independence. That's the point two. And the third point is that what? The return of ex-servicemen. Yes, this point really speaks volume about our perception about the whites. Initially, Okay, let me tell you about the ex-servicemen. The ex-servicemen were those that went to fight the first, those that went to fight the Second World War for Britain. You know, the Second World War was between 1939 to 1945. So those that went there to fight on behalf of what? On behalf of British, you know, we are still, Nigeria was still British colony. So they can easily pack any of our citizens to understand that situation. So those men that went to fight that one, came back successfully, were the one we refer to as what? Ex-servicemen. So when these people returned, the ex-servicemen, those that went to fight the war, their experience, when they narrated their experience of the war, we came to some realizations. Prior to their going to the war front, Nigerians, Africans, and third other world countries sees the whites, the colonialists, as gods. We see them as mini gods. We see them as people that cannot, those things that we human, we other black could be affected by, we believe they could not. They cannot die as we are dying. You know, like ordinary, an African man can be killed by a gun. So we believe this white was so superior that God cannot kill the black, that he was so superior to us. That was our perception about them. But when these servicemen went to the war front, and at the war front they observed that the whites were dying as black were dying. That the whites were not even superior in any way. That even the black, after being shot, can still withstand the what? The bullets to even kill one or two persons more. But it was the case in the whites. So when they were supposed that even, we're even stronger than these people. So how could they have now picked us as slaves? How would they be ruling over us? This is unfair. So that mentality actually changed when they returned. So the change in mentality of belief and orientation affected our activities. Hated us and improved the what? The belief, the agitations, the yearning of the nationalists to fight against the colonial masters. So the return of ex-servicemen really opened our eyes to a lot of things and increased our activities against colonialism. Another point we should look into what is the British the activity of British Labour Congress. Of course, one of the essence of Labour Congress. Labour Congress it's like a pressure group that fights for the interest of its members. So this group was based in British actually. It's the Labour Congress in the British. But when they observed the way Africans were being used to execute their objectives, like the way they were being maltreated, the way they were being underpaid, they were being given peanuts, they were using their resources, using their manpower, using their land resources, using their economic power, using everything about Africa, yet they were being given peanuts. So this set of processes were what? They felt the guilt that no, this is inhuman. This is inhuman of us. So they themselves were now agitating, fighting on behalf of weak blacks against their government. And no, allow these people, let them rule themselves. Let them govern themselves. This is unfair. This is an unfair treatment. Would you have allowed others to do that to us? Of course, they wouldn't. So the activities of this body also what goes a long way to help us in getting through independence. And another factor we should look into is what? The agitation of the United Nations. Of course, United Nations sought to, there was League of Nations actually before United Nations. You know, United Nations was formed in 1945. So League of Nations was in operation before that time. But League of Nations failed because the essence of United Nations is to prevent the Third World War now. So after the First World War broke out, they established League of Nations to prevent the outbreak of Second World War. But they could not prevent it when Adolf Hitler started the Second World War in Germany in 1939. So by implication, League of Nations failed in its mission to prevent the outbreak of Second World War. So therefore, after the Second World War in 1945, United Nations was formed. So one of the factors that could prevent Third World War was what? Giving independence to countries that were being ruled over. Why? Because if they do not, this country can also rise and give room for another thing. So the United Nations were now agitating on behalf of what? On behalf of the oppressed countries. Yes, I said oppressed. Yes, we are being oppressed. We are being maltreated. We are being denied our rights. They were scavenging on our rights and maltreating us at the same time. So United Nations, to a very large extent, also what? Agitated for our rights and helped us in ensuring that what? The countries that were being colonized had their independence. So as a result of all these activities, Nigerians, to an extent, were granted a partial independence as far back as 1951, because that was when we had federalism. We had we sowed the seed of federalism. Richard Constitution of 1946 sowed the seed of federalism. And since then, what we call regionalism. We have both the northern, the western, and the eastern region. And then in 1951, Awolowo became what? The premier of the western region. So, we have been granted partial independence. And remember, in the Constitutional Conference of 1953, though we still discuss constitutional development in Nigeria, where we discuss all these things. In the Constitutional Development of 1953, in the Constitutional Development Conference of 1953, it was agreed that any country, of 1951, that any country, like, that Nigeria should agitate for self-independence. And in 1953, Anthony Ahenaro moved a motion for self-government, that there should be self-governance in 1956, though it was countered by what? By the Northerners. That no, Nigeria should only be granted independence as soon as practicable, but not yet. So, which later delayed our independence to 1960. Though, it was just what? It was a flag independence. As our president, Nnamdi Azikiwe, was still representing, he was not president as of 1960. He was only a governor general representing the Queen of England until 1963, when we became a Republican, when we can actually say we had a real independence. But yet, we are still under what we call neocolonialism. Capitalism and imperialism are still in operation up to today. See what China is doing to us. Pouring us money. All this. And yet we're paying debt upon debt. Imperialism is still happening. Neocolonialism, advanced way of colonizing us. Okay, these are the factors that lead to nationalist activities in Nigeria. And we'll be looking now into what? Effect of nationalism. What are the effects of nationalism? One of the effects is that what? It builds a robust political formation in Nigeria. Yes, it was as a result of nationalist activities that we had many political parties that came on board. This one, everybody was agitating. So there were what? There was more informed political situation. More what? More informed political situation. There was what? More political, what we call political awareness. Increased political awareness. That's one. Increased political awareness. That's one. Another factor is that what? There was a solid information system in Nigeria. And this is what? The mass media, which was the main route through which what? They disseminate information. So the role of the mass media cannot be underestimated as far back as then. Another thing is that what? There was a good political structure. Yes. Good political structure. They actually established a good political structure in Nigeria. But the problem is, it is not the system that matters. But it is the people that want to execute the system. No matter how beautiful a system of governance is, if the people that are meant to execute it are not beautiful, that system will be the ugliest one to you. You can imagine, we operated a Westminster system in 1963. We operated a parliamentary system. But we agitated in 1979, we changed it to presidential. What's the case? Has there been any difference? No. So it's not the system that actually matters. It's the people that execute the system. So, the effects are what? They were groomed politicians. Yes. We have politicians that were deeply groomed. Old politicians, we have what other thing? So these are the factors, these are the benefit factors. Yes, we have many informed Nigerians, many Nigerians that were aware of the political activities, many increase in political participation. There was what? Increase in political participation. Yeah, increase in political participation. So all these factors see to successful agitation against colonialism in Nigeria. So thank you very much. I appreciate you for watching this video. If you think you have gained something from it, I think others can benefit. Kindly share with your friends and family. Thank you.